Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to print out only a portion of a document. Now, let's say you only want to print out a portion of something you're looking at. Say it's a web page or an email or a document you're working on. You just want to really quickly print something that's just an excerpt from it instead of all the pages or a page that's filled with graphics. Well, there's a quick and easy way to do this that works across all applications. So as an example, say you're looking at the tech specs at the Apple website for a MacBook Pro. And you've got all this information here in graphics and you just want to print out a small portion of it. Like say the list here of the inputs and outputs. So you've got that right here. You just want to print that out. Well, an easy way to do that is you just do Command-P for print. And it's going to be a multi-page document here. I'm going to go down to where at the bottom it says PDF, and you probably already know that you could save as a PDF instead of printing to paper. But you can also do Open PDF and Preview, which really quickly prints it out to a PDF document and opens it in Preview. So we get to see it here in Preview, and we can see that there are a lot of different pages, all the different pages here, but we only want to print that one section we are looking at, this one right here, which will save a lot of paper from printing out the entire thing. Well, it would be great to be able to select this area and print it, but if we try to select it, we see it's going to select it as text here, which isn't going to save the formatting. We can also hold down the Option key and select an area, but it's still going to just select it as text. So the cool thing that we could do here is we could go to Tools and change to Rectangular Selection. So now, when we select, it selects an area like that. Now, we can copy that and paste that into a new document. Edit, Copy, and then File, New from Clipboard. And the keyboard shortcuts are Command-C, Command-N. So very quickly, just by hitting those two keyboard shortcuts, I create this new preview document that just has this section in here. Now, the cool thing about this is it actually is a PDF document. If I were to zoom in on it, I can see that the text will zoom in properly. If I had simply just taken a screenshot, that's another technique you could use for the same thing. Take a screenshot of that area, then it's bitmap. So if I zoom in on it, I can see the pixels. Here, this is the real thing. It's real text. And I have this quick little document here now that I could print. I don't even have to save it. Matter of fact, I probably won't. And I'll just print this text here. I won't waste paper printing the rest of the document. Now, another option that you can use for single page documents, close this document, I'm not going to use it, is you can use the crop here. So once I've selected a rectangular area, again switching your tools to rectangular selection, or simply bringing up the tools here by hitting this icon, and then I can hit this here for rectangular selection, select, I can then hit the crop button, but look what's going to happen there is it's going to crop it. Just that one page. So I still have the other pages. Here's page 2, here's page 4. Page 3 is cropped to this. So for multi-page documents it doesn't work as well as the copy and new document from Clipboard. So once you've done this a few times it becomes very easy and quick. You just print, go to the PDF button and select to open it in Preview, switch to rectangular selection area, copy, and new document from Clipboard, and then you can print that section. And this works for anything. So if we wanted to print a portion of something you're working on, for instance, that's great. It also is fantastic for when you want to print out tickets and you notice that the page is filled with advertisements and all sorts of things you don't actually need on the page. You just need the information that is actually part of the ticket. You can basically just copy that portion of the page and then just print that and save all the ink and paper from printing the rest of it. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it'll just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.